gonna go down real quick.
Alright.
The other one's gonna go down real quick. It's really close. It's going down now. Yeah, we can probably get the pump. Start running away before we get done.
Well, this should be pretty easy. Just get to come along, strap to the big piling here, lift up the stern, and start pumping it out.
These freaking people start to piss me off.
It's always something.
Yep. They don't check their boats at all. I don't know how they even do it.
That's the biggest problem I've seen.
They leave them in and go out of town.
Yeah.
I don't understand that.
We've had a few calls for people that their boats need salvage and they're like in Key West or up north. Just go to the D-ring on the back of the boat. That'll be the easiest thing. That came up way easier than I thought it would.
Yeah, he's not here.
made it a lot easier, didn't it?
That came up much easier than I thought it would.
I figured you put bags on it. I'm gonna go try to pump that one out.
Okay.
Yeah, I went up north all summer.
Idiot. Probably never even knew we had a hurricane coming. Empty in here. Something that you could use the discharge hose to help prime the pump.
Did you
need one of these.
Yeah.
How much one of them things on?
I want to say it's like 250 at Harbor Freight.
That's it?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
There comes a time when the big dewatering pump is too powerful. And a bunch of different bulkheads in this boat. There's water in each one of them, but only a tiny little hole to go between them. And so this pump just keeps emptying one, and then runs out of prime before the water from the other ones can flow into it. I feel like I got the little electric filled pump going right now. Well, that concludes pumping out this boat. We've got another one over there. I don't know if you guys can see it. Waiting to hear back from the guy on his insurance because we might be heading right over there to pump that one out as well. So, if so, you guys will see that next week.